Hi viewers, I'm Nadeem.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to the Farooq Academy. Today we will discuss chapter number 7, the one book, exercise 7A, algebraic equations and simple inequalities. My dear students, open your textbook. You can see in question number 1, you have been asked that find the solution of each of the following. Question number 1, A part, 3a minus 4 is equal to a. My dear students, whenever you have been asked that find the solution, that it means we have to find the variables that a and x or y, anything which have been given in the form of variables. So these are considered to be the variables, so we have to find the value of this. So shifting this one towards this side, this is known as sign of equality. So 3a minus a is equal to, and constant should be shifting here, so the coefficient sign should be changed here, minus 4, it becomes positive 4. So no need to write positive sign. So 3a minus a, it gives you 2a, and the value of a is, because 2 multiplied here, it will be shifted here in division form, so you will get a is equal to 2. So the value of a is 2. This is the solution of question number 1a part. Now coming to the question number b part, 50 minus 5a is equal to 10. Now my dear students, you are well familiar to this fact that constant terms should be shifting at one side and variable at one side, as we have done in question number 1. So by shifting this, it becomes minus 50, because here 50 is positive. So it will give you minus 40, because the sign of greater value should be used here. So minus 5a. So minus and minus will be cancelled, because here is a sign of equality. So you have 5a is equal to 40, and a is equal to 40 divided by 5. So you will get 8. So 8 is your result. Now coming to the C part, 24 by a is equal to 3. So my dear students, whenever you find the sign of equality, so you can use cross multiplication. So by using cross multiplication, cross multiplication method, so you will get 24 is equal to 3a. You have to find the value of a, so 3 will be divided here, so you will get a is equal to 8, or simply a is equal to 8, because unknown quantity often right at left hand side. So that is your result. Now coming to the D part, 1 by 2a minus 1 by 3a is equal to 2. So my dear students, whenever you find a positive or negative sign in 2 over form or oblique form, so you have to take the LCM. So here is your LCM, that is 6, because after multiplying these two terms you will get 6. And you know, also find the value of LCM like this, 2 ones are 2, 3. We have discussed earlier that now we have to divide with 3, you will get 3 1s are 6, 3 2s are 6. Multiply these two terms, you will get the LCM. So here 6 is your LCM. And you know, whenever you find the LCM 6, then LCM will be divided by the denominator of first term. So 3 2s are 6. And this 3 will be multiplied with the numerator 1. So you will get 3a. Similarly, 2a is equal to 2. Now you can use cross multiplication. So 2 multiplied by 6, 12, and 3a minus 2a, you will get a. So 12 will be the result. Now coming to the question E part, 3 by 4a minus 3 is equal to 1 by 2a. Now once again, my dear students, the variable quantity should be shifted towards one side and constant quantity will be shifted towards the other side. So you will get it becomes positive and it becomes negative, because here is positive 1 by 2a. So taking LCM, so you have to take the LCM 2, 2, 2, 4 and 2. So you will get 4 will be the LCM, and repeat the same methodology of question number 1, you will get 3a and 2a is equal to 3 by using cross multiplication method. 4 3s are 12, and 3a minus 2a, it will give you a. So once again you find the value of a. Now coming to the next part, part number f, that is 1 by 3a minus 3 is equal to 0. So constant terms should be shifted towards next side, that is positive 3, 1 by 3a. Now you have to find the value of a using cross multiplication. It will give you 3 3s are 9. So the value of a is 9. Now coming to the g part, that is 1.5a plus 2 is equal to 5. Again by the same methodology, shifting 1.5a, you will get 3. 1.5a, you have to find the value of a, so it will be divided by this one. So the value of a is, if you divide, there are two methods, you can also solve by the other method also, but if you divide it, you will get 2. So the value of a is 2. Now coming to the next part, that is h part, (0.5a − 1) = 4. So again by the same method, shift the constant quantity at one side, you will get 5a. So 0.5a, you have to find the value of a, so 0.5 will be divided here, and the value of a is divide. I have already told you, my dear students, you can also solve this question when you remove the decimal sign, then also you can solve it. For example, now it is a clear method, first you have to solve by simple method, you will get 10. Or if you don't have calculator or idea, so how can you solve? For example, other method, you can see here the value of a is 5 by 0.5, so you have to remove the point, you will have to put 1, and how many digits you have to put 0, so it is your 5 by 5 by 10. So invert it, 5 multiplied by 10, you will get 5. So again 5 will be cancelled, you will get 10 results. So by the same method, if you remove the decimal sign, you can also solve and you will get the same result as we have simple division we have got. Okay madam, now coming to the next question, question number 2. If a is an integer, find the possible solutions if any. So a part, a square is equal to 4. How can you remove the square sign? You have to take root sign both sides. So the value of under root is 1 by 2 and it will give you 2 cross 2 and you will get 2, and here 2 will be cancelled, so a is equal to 2. So my dear students, you know when we have to remove the squares and we have to take the root sign both sides, or when you remove the, for example, under root, then what should you do? Then you have to take the squaring both sides, because the value of root is 1 by 2, so it will be cancelled with this one. So this is the simple few important methods which we have discussed in early lectures. So now coming to the b part, 9 minus a square is equal to 0. So shift here, it will become positive. So you have to remove this square. So taking root sign both sides, and again by the same method you will get 3 cross 3, 3 is a 9, and the value of under root is 1 by 2, so it will be cancelled with this one and you will get 3a. So the value of a is, so the value of a is 3. So here is your b part. Now coming to the part number c. A square plus 16 is equal to 0. A square is equal to minus 16. So you have to find the a, so taking under root both sides, so you will get a is equal to 4 fours are 16. So you will get 4, and the negative will give you the negative sign. So my dear students, you have to memorize this, that the any integer such as square is always positive. Any integer square is always positive. Therefore you have seen here we have a minus. So if we see mathematically, so we have calculated it is 4, but the negative square root cannot be obtained. It can be obtained by other complex numbers, so it is beyond the course of your lecture. So solution is not possible. Actually a solution is not possible, but we have numerically value calculated which is not seem to be the accurate, but it is a wrong solution. But solution is not possible, solution doesn't exist, so the value of a is not possible. Now another d part you can see here. A under root is equal to 5. Now how can we remove the root sign? So taking square both sides, I have already told you, you have to take the square to remove the root sign. So it will give you 25, and the value of root is 1 by 2, and 2 will be cancelled with each other, so you will get only 25. So here is the so. Now coming to the e part, a index 3 and equal to 3. How can you find the index 3? You first you have to write in a simple form, that is your 1 by 3. It means 1 by 3 is equal to 3. Now you have to taking cube both sides, 3 3, so you will get 3 3s are 9 9 3s are 27, and 3 3 will be cancelled, so the value of a is 27, because you have to calculate the value of a. So here is the solution. Now coming to the next part, that is g part. A plus 4 index 3 is equal to 4. Now again a plus 4, what does that mean? It means 1 by 3. So you have to take the cube both sides to cancel the 1 by 3. So taking cube both sides, you will get 64. 3 4 4s are 16. 16 4s are 64. And this will be cancelled. So you will get a plus 4. Now again you have got the same equation as we had discussed earlier, that constant term should be shifted towards one side. So shift here, minus 4, you will get 2. So the value of a is 2. So here is the solution. Now coming to the last part of this exercise, that is h part. 2a plus 1 under root is equal to 7. How to find the under root sign? Or you have to take the square both sides. Squaring both sides,
by the same as squaring both sides, so you will get 2a plus 1 7. So you will 4 4 7 7 are 49, and the value of root sign will be cancelled with this one. You will get 2a plus 1, so 2a plus 1 is equal to 49. Again shifting constant towards one side, so 2a, so you will get 48, and the value of a is 48 divided by 2, you will get 2 to the 4 to the 8, so 24 is your result. So my dear students, we have completed exercise number 7a. I hope you that it will be very much beneficial to you. Thanks a lot. Thank you for watching.